Don't worry, there are no spoilers in this video. I wanted to put together a video that will help you guys because as I've been playing through Final Fantasy's new expansion Endwalker, or trying to play through the new Endwalker expansion, the queue times are a little jacked up right now. There are quite a few things that I forgot about that you could be doing during the main story while you're playing. And the reason you wanna start doing some of these things is it's gonna take a long time in order to get some of this stuff done. So you wanna start as soon as possible, because these are daily and weekly things that you don't want to forget about. Plus, I had to take a break to make some content because the Final Fantasy Endwalker expansion story is just wrecking me. So I needed a little break to make some content for you guys and hopefully help you out as you start the new story. So let's just jump right into it. The first thing, and if you had watched my previous videos, you might have done this, hopefully you did. You'll wanna play with your battle class retainer job. A lot of people are leveling up Reaper and Sage, and that's amazing. I don't pay your sub, you can do whatever you want. But if you have your battle class retainers, they're not gonna be able to level up until you level up your main job. So my battle class retainers are Black Mage. So I'm playing through the story with Black Mage in order to start leveling up my retainers. It is gonna take a long time. Just the first level from 80 to 81, it took 7 quick ventures, which means that if it increases at all, right there is already 7 hours times 10, that's gonna be 70 hours, but it's probably gonna take more as you get closer to 90. So it's gonna take many of us weeks in order to get our retainers to level 90, not let alone our actual job to level 90. So if you're thinking about starting Endwalker's expansion by leveling up another class, just consider maybe playing through with your main battle class in order to start leveling up those retainers. Speaking of retainers, if you have gatherer retainers, that leads me to tip number 2. As you're playing through the story and you have your gatherers at level 80, which many people do, not everyone, but many people do, then you can start leveling them and getting your retainers leveled as well. What I mean is, as you're going through the story, most likely you're gonna come across miner nodes and botanist nodes, and those are gonna be really valuable to start collecting at least just one of each of the items. This is so then later your retainers are able to go back and collect these items for crafting and other things. The other thing that I was doing as I was playing through the main story is I was collecting leaves. So I would go pick up the leaves from the main city, and as I was playing, I was practically walking straight through the leave that I needed to do, and then I would just wait to turn it in once I got back to the main city. So that's another really good way to level up your gatherers as you're playing, so you can start kind of doing the balancing act that we all try to do pretty much while we're playing this game. Oh my gosh, speaking of leveling crafters and gatherers, I totally forgot about Grand Company turn-ins. Those are the turn-ins that we use to level up crafter and gatherers, as well as your expert delivery missions, which we'll talk about in a minute. But for your Grand Company turn-ins, this is such an easy way to start getting experience for your crafters and gatherers. You might find that on your server, it's very expensive because a lot of the people are crafting and making those things for you to buy at an exorbitant price right now because it's the new expansion and they're trying to make some money. So I wouldn't spend anything above the regular few thousand for those high quality items. And like on my server, I saw some things go for 100,000, 200,000, which I was like, I'm not gonna buy it, I can just make it myself. But it's still worth going to the market board and looking to see if you can snag anything for really cheap. Usually the gatherer items are still really cheap to level up your gatherers, so you can balance out doing the leaves and the collecting of nodes, as well as the alchemist and culinarian items are usually pretty easy to get. I haven't had a problem getting those, and those are the ones that are leveling up a little bit quicker. Once you turn in those things, consider looking for the star that's next to the Grand Company turn in, and if there is a star, maybe you might want to take the time to make that particular item because that gives you bonus experience. And now that we don't have high quality turn-ins for gathering, then you might wanna do those specific ones to make sure that you get that extra experience for gatherer. And since we're on the topic of Grand Company, let's talk about expert deliveries. Make sure to roll on your gear. You guys know how I feel about this. I put out a video called Sprouts Always Miss This, and it's an old video, but it still holds true today. Do not roll on your gear. If you're playing through the dungeon, roll greed on everything. If someone needs it, they will be able to grab it from you by hitting need if it's for their class. Most people don't need the gear at this point, and you're just throwing grand company seals down the drain by not rolling at all. On top of that, doing quick ventures with your retainers while leveling them up is gonna net you a lot of gear, as well as some glamour, so make sure you're checking those items that you're getting. If not, you can be selling them, desynthesizing them, and turning those in for grand company seals too. So this is just a really great way to start stocking up on ventures, cordials, and all sorts of other things that are available for grand company. Raise your hand if you're like me and you always forget to do the Wondrous Tales. Do not forget to pick up this book every single Tuesday, as it resets every Tuesday, but it takes 2 weeks to expire. So make sure when you're doing all these duties and all these other things to level up your alt jobs that you pick up the Wondrous Tales right there at Idleshire. That is such a difficult word to say for me for some reason. Let's quickly shift over to the last topic, and that is the Ether Compass. So with the new expansion, we're going to have to collect Ether Currents again. Ether Currents are going to be around the map, as well as part of some blue unlock quests for that zone. Ether Compass is no longer a key item. It got moved to collections. So I recommend that you go into your collections menu and put the Ether Compass on one of your hotbars or cross hotbars. The reason for this is that you're going to be using it a lot, so you might as well get used to it and have it on a hotbar, because you're going to want to collect these ether currents as you're playing through the story. There is nothing more frustrating than having to walk the map when you're so used to flying everywhere. So make sure that you have your ether compass, and you even can put the ether current so you can see how many you have. And I think that they updated the ether compass. It's so accurate and so easy, and you can use it while you're on a mount and other things to make it really more quality of life for us players. So make sure that you're using that regularly, so then you can get the ether currents. There's again usually about 7 or 8 for the map, and then 4 or 5 for the quest. So just keep looking at the ether current section to see which ones you're missing, and even if you're really far away, it will still show up. It will just say you're 700 ilms away. These are just a few things that I wanted to make sure to let you guys know, because you want to start doing that balance act again. The story is so incredibly long and really dense. And bonus, 90% voice acted, which I'm absolutely loving. Make sure that you start putting on your balancing hat and doing these daily things and not getting lost in the story, because you'll kind of be behind in other areas. That's just my personal advice to you. If you got any value out of this video, then make sure to limit break 3, that subscribe button down below, and hit that notification bell so you can see all my new Endwalker videos coming out. You can also find my Discord down below if you want to connect with me and be a part of a really great community. They're very active right now because of Endwalker out and helping each other and all sharing in the joy. If you consider supporting the channel, you can also find that in my link tree down below. If you want to watch more Final Fantasy Endwalker tutorials and guides, then you can click here.